Hello friends, welcome to the VLSI design course. So today we are going to write a VHDL code for 4-bit up counter as well as the down counter, and we are going to realize it on the FPGA development board. Okay, so in earlier lecture we have seen how to write a 4-bit up counter, then we have written a VHDL code for the 4-bit down counter also, and we have seen a simulation, right? So by using that concept, so we are combining that implementation and we'll try to implement on the real-time hardware platform. So let's start. So to implement on the development board, we are going to use a 7-segment display. So here we are going to write a 4-bit up counter. Okay. And we wanted to display the count value up to 999. So each counter is run as a 4-bit and we are going to use a 3-digit counter. Okay, so 3-digit counter. So what are the inputs for my count signal or for this counter design? So we are going to use definitely a synchronous circuit, so clock signal, as well as we are going to use a start switch or start signal, so that whenever we say the start, then and then our counter will start from, let us say initially it will start from the 00. If you say it is a start and then it will check for the up down signal. If it is up, then it will start incrementing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. Okay, so it will go increasing, let us say 9, then 10, then 11, 12, like so. It will increment up to 999 in case of if up is equal to 1. But if it is up is equal to 0, it will start down counting. So from instead of 00, it will start 999, then 998. So like that, it is going to decrement. So what we are going to do, for each digit, we are writing a 4-bit counter. Yes, 4-bit counter. Okay. So let us say, if this 4-bit counter is started incrementing, let us say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So initial value. So let us erase it. I will just show you the logic. So let us start with the initial value. If all the counter values are 0, then what to do? In case of up counter, we are going to increment this. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So let us say we reach up to the 9. What we have to do? So let us say this is count 1. We are giving this as a name count 1, count 2, and count 3. So what we have to do, when it count 1 reaches to the 9, we have to increment this count and make this count is equal to 0, right? Then whenever it reaches to the now, this count will increment by the 1. So like that we have to implement a logic. So in next state, what will happen? Again it will become 0, then it will on each rising edge of the clock it will increment 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Once it reaches to the 9, again it will increment by 1. So here it will become 2 0. Then 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29. Again, it reaches to 9. This counter will goes on increasing, right? So 20, it will become 30. So like that, it will happen. Let us assume this condition. If it is becomes to 99. So because of 9, this counter is incremented by 1. And once this count becomes 9, we have to increment this count by 1. So from 0, it becomes incremented by 1, right? It is incremented by 1 and 9, the next one is 00. So like that, we are going to write a VHDL code to up count as well as for the down count. I hope you understood this logic. Once you start writing a VHDL code, that time we can understand it in a better way. Okay. So let us draw a small state diagram, how our code will be looks like. So let us start with the initial state. So I'm writing here initial state. So during initial state, and we have taken a clock signal. So on each and we are using a rising edge of the clock. So on each and each rising edge, we have to increment the counter. But before that, we have some conditions. Now, if start is equal to 0, we will still remain in a initial state. But if start is equal to 1, let us assume there is a next state, let us say up. Now, we are in a up state. If there is another one signal up, down is equal to 1, we are in a up state, we are going to increase the count. So, count is equal to count plus 1. But if we are in a up state, but immediately if we change the up down signal to 0, up underscore down is equal to 0, we are going in a down state. Try to understand. So in down state, what we are doing, going to do, count is equal to count minus 1. So here decrement will happen. If we are in a down state, okay, so in up state, if 0 comes, if up down signal is 0, we are start down counting. We are in up state, but if up down is 1, we will stay in the same state and our count will go on increasing. Now if we are in up state and if reset is start is equal to 0, we are going back to the initial state. So if start is equal to 0, again in down state, already if start is equal to 1, we are firstly checking the up down signal. If it is 1, we are staying here. If it is 0, going to the down state. If we are right now, if we are in a down state, we have to go back when start is equal to 0. So it is go back to the, every time when start is equal to 0, it will go to initial state and there our counter value will be halt. So counter, count is equal to count will be halted here. So in this state, in initial state, we are going to keep count value as it is. Once again, if start is equal to 1, it will check up down signal and accordingly it will start from that count value only. Have you understood? So here we are going to halt our counter also if there is a no start signal. Okay, so let us begin to start writing a VHDL code, and there we can understand better how to write a VHDL code. So as per this implementation, so let's begin it. So create a new project, file, new project. So I'm going to write a counter up down. Okay, so I'm creating a new project, counter up down. Other things are same, exactly same family, same FPGA. Now new VHDL module. So this counter will go up to 999, up counter or down counter. So next, now here what are the signals? We have a clock signal, right? Then we have a start signal, right? Input as well as up underscore down. Now we are going to use the 7-segment display. So for the 7-segment display, and the 7-segment display, if you see here, it is a multiplex. So all the segments are connected to a common signal. So we have only 7-segment outputs. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay. So we need to declare SSD underscore out. That is only single output for all the 7 segments. So it is out and total bus width is total 7 segments. So 6 down to 0. Now for the control of all these 7 segments, we have SSD1, SSD2, SSD3, SSD4, SSD5 and SSD6, right? So total we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7-segment control. So already we have studied this, how to drive this 7-segment display. So my request is to go back and watch our earlier videos where we have implemented a 4-bit BCD to 7-segment display. Okay, so whatever the values we are giving from the input 4 switches, it is displaying on the 7-segment display. Okay, so today we are going to understand how this multiplexing is working. next, finish. Okay, so our initial declaration done here. So, but here we are going to use a adder. So we have to declare a package unsigned.all, right? So once you declare this, it will not give an error whenever you are using a adder or subtraction operator. Okay, so as I said, this is a sequential circuit, definitely. So being a sequential circuit, we are going to use a process statement. So process clock begin. Now if we are checking every time if clock tick event and clock equal to 1, so on each rising edge, what we are going to do then? Okay, so on each rising edge, we have to first check if start is equal to 1, then. So as per the our algorithm or flow diagram, if start is equal to 1, we have to go in up state. Then in up state means we are going to check this up down signal. Okay, now now here I am going to check if up down signal is 1, then what we are going to do now we have to increment the first first digit counter. So here I am going to give this counter name as a count underscore ssd1. So this is ssd1, ssd2 and ssd3. So I am giving a counter name signal, internal signal, as a 4 bit signal, count underscore ssd1. So we need to declare that signal. So signal count underscore ssd1 of type std underscore logic. So I will copy this to save the time. Control V, and but here we are going to use as a 4 bit. So count underscore ssd1 is equal to 3 down to 0. Now this count, so whenever it is a up count, so first counter I am going to increment plus 1. Okay, now if up down is equal to 1 and we are going to increment count ssd1 is equal to count ssd1, after that we have to check now if this count ssd is equal to 9. Okay, if it is a 9, sorry, then what we have to do, as I said, we have to increment if this is 9, we have to increment the second count. So that is ssd underscore, so count underscore ssd2 we have to increment. Count underscore ssd2 is equal to count underscore ssd2 plus 1, right? Now again here we need to declare that signal, so I am just copy it. So count ssd2 comma control V, count ssd2 also we declare. After reaching here, what we have to do, we have to make this count ssd equal to 0000. Okay, then now if it is a else section, or we can do to complete the if statement, we'll do else, or simply we can end if, keep it running. Sorry, we'll do one thing to complete the, to avoid the latch generation, we'll do one thing. We'll write a else statement. Here it will end and end if. So what I have done, whenever there is rising edge, it will first check the start. If start is equal to 1, then it will check the up down. If up is there, it will go here. If count is equal to count ssd1 is 9, no, initially it is definitely 0, then it will come here else count is equal to count plus 1, count ssd1 is will incrementing by 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. If ssd1 reaches to the 9, it will increment the second SSD incrementation and SSD 1 value become 0. Till now I think we have understood. Now if, so this section I am copying as it is. Now if SSD 2 is equal to 9, then we have to increment SSD 3. Got it? So this SSD 3 also we need to declare as a 4-bit internal signal. So SSD 3, got it? So if SSD 3 incremented, then we have to make SSD 1, SSD 2 as a 0, right? Else SSD 2 is equal to SSD 2 plus 1, got it? Similarly, for the last third digit, if count SSD 3 is now, if it is a 9, then here we have to make all the SSD outs 0. I will explain this. Now what I have done, okay, so try to understand this concept first. Okay, if count underscore SSD 1 is equal to 9, so initial data size and everything is 0, so it will not enter here, it will go here, it will start incrementing it, correct? Then if it reaches to the 9, it will start incrementing the next SSD count. So SSD 2 will start incrementing, and immediately that time SSD 1 will become 0. So SSD 2 will start incrementing. Then if the execution comes here, it will check if SSD 2 is 9. No. If SSD 2 is not 9, then it will start incrementing the SSD 2, right? It will start incrementing the SSD 2. Okay. But the problem is here. So here it will start incrementing. Sorry, here I think one mistake will happen. If it is an L, so every time this also will increment. So to avoid this, we cannot do like this. So wait. So it should be like this. So let us do it like this. Okay. And this else also should not be there. So on every rising edge, only SSD 1 we are incrementing, not any other SSD count. Got it? So whenever there is rising edge, only SSD 1 will increment, and others are dependent on these conditions. Right? So on each rising edge, only SSD 1 will increment. If it is a 9, SSD 2 is incremented, SSD 1 is 0. If SSD 2 is a 9, we are incrementing SSD 3, and both the SSDs we are making it here 0. So SSD 2 also 0, SSD 1 also 0. And if it reaches to the SSD 3 9, so all the SSDs are we are making 0. Got it? So this is the up counter section, right? Else, so we are going to write the else section of this up down. So else means it is a down counter. So everything is exactly same. What we are going to do, I'm just copy and do the paste over here. Okay, so else means here up underscore down is equal to 0. Up underscore down is equal to 0, right? Now if it is a 0, so we have to do the down counting, right? So in down counting, we have to subtract it, right? So this is subtraction. Now here the condition is reverse. So it will start down counting from 0, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Now here we have to compare, if it is a 0, if it is a 0, we have to subtract, decrement the SSD2, right? And what we have to do, we have to make this SSD count 1 as a 9, because this is a reverse method. So if now SSD 2 is 0, by decrementing it, if it is become 0, we have to decrement the SSD 3, right? And accordingly SSD 2 will be 1, sorry, it should be 9, and SSD 1 should be 9. Similarly, if SSD 3 becomes by decrementing 0, okay, so if it reaches to the 0, we have to make it to the 9. Got it? Okay, so like this else part we have covered. Now this up down is over. Now remaining condition is the start. If start is equal to 0, what we are going to do? Now this is this if and the this end if for the for up down signal, right? Now next else, this else is for the if start is equal to 0. If start is equal to 0, what we are going to do? This count SSD 3 is equal to count SSD 3. So control C. Okay, count SSD 3 is equal to count SSD 3. Count SSD 2 is equal to count. So we are halting the counter value. So whatever the count value is there, it will remain as it is. So that is the reason we are. Then this end if. This end if for start signal. And the last end if for clock signal, right? So I am just giving for better understanding. And last is the end process. Just save it and check the syntax, right? So welcome back. So in previous video we are able to write up counter logic as well as the down counter logic. So here this we have just written an internal logic for the up and down counter. Now this value we have to give it to the SSD out, that is 7 segment display, right? So but here the 7 segment display, whatever we have used is a the 7 segment display, whatever we have used is a single or it is a multiplexing. So whatever the value we are assigning to the 7 segment, so it is going to the other 7 segment display also. Okay, got it? Now to avoid that confusion, we have to implement a multiplexing logic. So for that what we need to do, we need to assign the SSD out value during for some time this 7 segment this counter value to this 7 segment multiplexed output, right, at a one time only. So we have to implement a multiplexing logic at the back end of the program. So in that, what we are doing very fastly, even human eye cannot understand that change, so that we are going to assign it. So before that, let us I will show the problem what will happen during the multiplexing. So I will do one thing. Already I have written a code for these 7 segment out. So I will just write it here. So 7 segment output already we have written a code. So same thing I am going to use here. So this is my 7 segment output, right? 7 segment decoded output. So whenever there is a 0, this 0 will be displayed. So but here I will use a count underscore SSD1. So whenever count underscore SSD1 value is 0, it will assign to the SSD out, right? So this SSD out will be going to this output of the SSD out, right? Now we are going to control this SSD1, SSD2 and SSD3. So for that, what we have to do? We have to control this signal, so SSD. And all other SSD should be 0. Okay. So only one SSD I am enabling. But to display the 3 SSD, let us enable all 3. So I will show you the diff problem. What will happen? Okay. So let's save it. So let us say this is done to display our counter value. Now we have to generate a UCF file. Okay. Now to generate a UCF file, so I am going to use this UCF constraint. Let's copy it. So generate, right click, new source, implementation constraint file, counter underscore SSD, now we can say 999 UCF, next, finish. So UCF file, so I will copy it again, copy, paste. So this UCF file is we are going to create. So in this, by default clock location is P129, start is the first switch of the board, up down is second switch of that board, and this SSD, our SSD control signal as well as SSD out already we have covered in our earlier lecture. So my request, you go back and watch that video so you can understand this pin assignment also. So let us generate a bit file. So I will show you the problem whatever we are going to face it. So let's generate it, a bit file. So our bit file is generating now. So basically in this program still there are two problems. One is the multiplexing, because the values, whatever the SSD out, we have only one SSD out because SSDs are connected in multiplexing. So we have to manage that output, how to give to each separate SSD. And second one is the clock. So currently the counter we are running, it has the 12 megahertz. So definitely we cannot able to recognize it. So there are two small codes we need to add. After doing this exercise, I will show the problem. Then after that, we are going to add two programs. One is the clock divider, other one is the multiplexing logic. So let's see. I will open the file. Just I will load that bit file. Sorry, here counter up down, counter 999 bit. So program it. Okay, so our bit file, we have loaded it. So just go, coming back to our FPGA development board, so switch it. Now you can observe it here. What I wanted to show you, the problem here, the data is going to all these 3-7 segment, right? All these 3-7 segment, but we are unable to observe it, right? We are unable to observe it. Even though if you stop it, so whatever the last value you can see here, it will return. So everywhere it is showing the 6.
If I say it is a start, it is start up or down counting. Try to understand. So this is start switch I am using. This is up down switch. So when it is a up is 1, this up switch is 1, it will be incrementing. But we are unable to observe the increment count. Why? Because this is incrementing at the rate of 12 megahertz. So we cannot observe that change by our human normal eyes, right? So I will just show you randomly. If I stop it, so whatever the previous last value, it is retaining here. So everywhere it is showing 4, 4, 4. So that is another one problem we are facing here. The segments we have connected, all these 6 segments, whatever we have used on our development board, they are connected as a multiplexing. So each segment, let us say A segment of all the 7 segments are connected to the single line. So whatever the data we are pushing, it is displaying on the all 6, 7 segments. So how to resolve that problem? So first of all, we need to divide a clock so that we can observe it. First thing we have to do that. So we have to divide the clock. And second thing what we have to do, we need to manage this multiplexing. So let's go back to our implementation. Okay, so what I will do, I will okay so what I will do what I will do I have already written that logic here for the multiplexing, so I will copy it. I will explain you. Again, I will explain you. So this I am going to now remove it. So this SSD control only we have to manage. Okay. So this SSD control only I am writing here. So I will little bit elaborate for you people. So if enable is equal to 00. So what we are going to do it. So here I have created a separate process which works on the clock. So if enable is equal to 0, so what is this enable? So I will explain first of all this enable thing. So for that also I have written separate logic. So inside the process, so there is again separate process clock tick event count and enable. Okay. This little bit confusing, definitely it will be a little bit confusing, but if you try by yourself, definitely you can understand. So this process is for the clock divider. So this method we are using as a clock divider method type 2. So I'm giving the names here. Let us say I'm giving the comment clock divider process. Okay, so this process is for clock divider, and as well as here we have done enable. So what we are going to do, we are going to take one count and that we are incrementing. So we have to declare that count with a very high bus width, so around 22 down to 0. So let us declare a signal. So as well that signal also we are going to copy from here. So signal count SSD control C as well as this enable. So why this enable has taken, that also I will try to explain you. Okay, and there is another one signal we have to declare here as a count underscore SSD. Okay, I try to understand. So this first process is works on the clock divider. Yes, here is the 12 megahertz clock. So on this 12 megahertz we are running one counter, and that counter has a bus width of let us say here how much 22 bits. Okay, so this is wide bus having 22 down to 0, so total width is 23. Now earlier we have seen a program where we have written a code for clock divider using method 1. In method 1 we have used a simple counter method, so my recommendation you go back and watch that video so you can understand how we have divided the clock. So once you, if you are using the 12th bit, so definitely our clock is divided like this, 12 mega. So how much clock it will be divided? It is 12 mega divided by 2 to the power of 22. Okay, so 2 to the power of 22, you got it? So this much clock will be divided. So clock divider value is how much? 12 mega divided by 2 to the power 12. So you calculate it, will come around the 1 hertz. Similarly, what we are going to do here, again here same concept. So we are using count value of 17 down to 16 for unable. So unable will become 12 mega divided by 2 to the power of maximum value is 17. So it is not exactly, it is few we can say hertz, few kilohertz or few hertz. So that unable pin we are going to use in our controlling the multiplexing. So coming back here, now if unable is equal to 0, we are enabling only SSD 1, all SSDs are 0. So this is the concept of fooling our eyes, human eyes. So at very high clock speed, we are at the back end, we are enabling SSD 1, and that time we are assigning the SSD count, SSD out value we are assigning by SSD 1 value is assigned to the SSD. Where enable is 01, SSD 2 value is assigned to the SSD, and that time only SSD 2 is enabled. Try to understand. And when it is a 10, we are enabling only SSD 3 and SSD count SSD 3's value assigned to the SSD. So this count SSD we have to assign to the his SSD, right? So all these common values, count SSD, count SSD, count SSD will come here and it will assign to a common SSD out, and accordingly our counter will generate. So this we have to disable now. So this completes our program, but this counter we have to work, or we have to increment on the clock divide signal. Okay, so whatever the clock we are dividing here, on that clock we have to work out this signal. Okay, so this process works on divided clock around 1 hertz. Okay, around 1 hertz, got it? So like this we are going to divide this clock. Okay, on this clock now everything will work. So already we have assigned the UCF file, no need to newly assign it. So let's generate a programming file. So it may take some time. Yes, now bit file is ready. Now let's load that bit file, whatever the generated bit file. So counter underscore 99 bit. So open and let's say the program. So immediately I'll switch to the FPGA development board. And now let's observe it, how it will change. Now it is programming. Once it is done, a blue LED will blink. It is not done. It should happen. Oh, it's failed. Why? So once again I'm trying. Yes, now you can observe it here. Our counter started automatically. So because of start is equal to 1, because of start is equal to 1, as well as this count up down counter value is 1, so it start up counting. When I make it up down count is equal to 0, you can observe it. Now it start counting from the back. So 999, like that it start from the 999. You got it? Now if I say halt, that is if I make start is equal to 0, what will happen? It will retain the last count value. Again, if I say start is equal to 1, whatever the condition, now it is in the down counter condition, or in a state, so it keep down counting. Again, if I make it halt, so it is 960, current value is 960. Again, if I start my counter, so my down counter is there, so it will start decrementing. So 959, 58, like that. Now if I make it up count, so immediately it will switch to initial condition 0 and it start incrementing from 1, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I hope this gives a very better idea how to implement a 3-digit counter on this development platform. So in this our development platform, we have a 6-7 segment display, so you can write or you can enhance this program for the further up down counters. I hope you have understood this in a better way. Keep watching this video. A lot more practical examples are coming up. Thank you.